Hello everybody and welcome back to Hubris. We are back and today we have a new building area. Oh my god, the sky is epileptic as fuck right now. Yes, so we have a new building area. Apparently I have flux flu. We have a new area. This isn't going to be a full-on building. It's going to be pretty much just a walk-in little shack area, I guess. Because I want to get some storage set up here for, like, barrels and stuff, just so we can stick a ton of stuff in here that we don't really have stuff. So things for, like, probably saplings, because we'll have a lot. Definitely sugarcane, because we have a lot of that. And those things that we have lots of. So that's primarily what that is going to be for. So we will do that in a few minutes. And also I have a new pickaxe. I went in to the dungeon area to see what I could find. I've actually found a wither room. So we could actually go face off against the wither if we really wanted to. But I want to get a bit more armor and stuff before I go and do that. But yeah, I got a new pickaxe because I needed to mine obsidian. And the Fortune 3 Tunnel 1 pickaxe just doesn't work for mining obsidian and stuff. So I came back and got myself a silk torch. Yes, you heard me right. A silk torch pickaxe. We also have shatter free so that it breaks through things a lot quicker. And it also has unbreaking one, so it shouldn't break quite as quickly. It's a shame that I couldn't get fortune on it, but my fortune pickaxe I will use for things such as mining. Whereas this one I will probably use more for, like, dirt or if I want to get... I won't be able to get double the ore because I don't have any machines for that sort of thing. But whatever, I'll be able to pick things up such as glass and stuff without it actually breaking. So that is that. Also, these are still not filled up, but I do have a way of doing this, which I finally found that rune that I needed, the rune of gluttony. That I had actually thought I'd lost a few episodes ago. It turns out it was actually in here. So we have the Rune of Winter, which we can move into the Rune of Gluttony if we have... Where is it? The Rune of Gluttony. We need a Rune of Fire and 2 Mana Diamonds, which luckily I found some diamonds over the time that we haven't really been doing episodes. So, yes, so we could get this. Magical girls are an option. Okay, not sure what this one does. And then there's this one which we can't actually get because we need pixie dust, which we can't currently get. So, yeah. Trying to think what else I've been doing between episodes. I don't think there's a whole lot. I've basically just been clearing the areas up, been doing a bit more research. Which, actually, there is a piece of Fulmic stuff that I also want to get today. But we are going to work on getting the other stuff first. So, we was requiring a Rune of Fire, which we do have now. And also, did I get the winter? Yes, I did. Right, so I believe it was 2 mana diamonds. So we will grab these 2 diamonds here. And we'll go make these into mana diamonds. So, boop. Boop. Oh yeah, you'll also realize that I got rid of the little chicken coop from over here. I've now got 2 chickens in here. Luckily, 1 laid an egg. So that was good. Right, we got that, right, so these should just go on here, I'm hoping. Here we go, and that, and then boop, and then I need to bind you to you, and I will also do the same for you, just so this will make the thing quicker. Actually, you won't even work, will you, because you don't have any power at the moment. So this should be making up very slowly. I will go and get some coal so that does it a little bit quicker. Mainly I went mining for coal and stuff but came back with some diamonds, so that was a pretty good and handy thing to do. Right, this should be making up. Oh wait, I need this selected, don't I? Yeah, that is slowly making up. Right, we will leave that for a few minutes while we go and get ourselves some barrels. Hopefully I have enough resources for this. Let's get a few alder wood. Right. Okay, so let's get this done. And we will make this into chests. Only 2 chests. I then need to get myself some slabs, which is pretty simple. And then we're going to stick the chest in the middle and get some oak wood logs around the outside. And we can get ourselves two chests there. We could probably get one more, actually. Let's just do that. So, like this. And then put an alder there. There we go. One more slab and one more load of oak wood. There we go. Okay, cool. Right, there we go. We got three barrels. I will definitely be making more because I want to fill this whole area up. Unless I put chests here instead, that might be another option that I will go with. But for now, we are going to stick with barrels. Still don't want this at the top. So, yep, there we go. We will stick this up here. There we go. Right. Okay, cool. So the first thing that I'm going to start putting in these barrels is, of course, going to be cobblestone. And the second thing is going to be dirt, because we need both of those, really. And cobblestone's a common thing to come by, and it's one of the most used ones that I have. So that can go in there. And then, of course, the second one is going to be dirt, because that's the second most thing that I really come across. So that's going to be that. And then on the bottom one, I'm just going to put sugarcane in for now, just so we can save. Actually, no. Oh, I just had an idea what I can put in that one. We have a whole chest of these damn golden coins. So what better reason to have a chest than, or to have a barrel for these things, right? That's half of them, I think. I should probably have my own row for, like, that sort of thing, really, which I don't know really how I want to set these out, so I guess Funcraft stuff can go along the bottom. I might actually move that one up to there. Right, you can go in there. I will pick you up. Then we'll break this. There we go. Get all that back. And we will stick this along the top row. There we go. There we go. Okay, cool. Right, so we got three barrels using up those. So we still have plenty more of those damn coins to get. But now at least we have an area for filling up if we have any of those sort of things that we have lots of stacks of, such as these lovely golden coins. Anything else in here that I could use? Doesn't look like it. Also doesn't really look like it. If there's anything over a stack, then I'll probably make a barrel for it. So, but for now, that will do. We've got, holy shit, 18 stacks of 64. Oh, that's a lot. That is a lot. Right, okay, cool. Oh, this is done. Good. Right, that means I need some living rock, which I don't believe that I actually have. Doesn't look to me that I do. Right, I guess I will have to go and make some up then. There we go. And into here we should have one unclaimed quest, which should be in remembering, which is the storage. There we go. So we've already made a wood to iron chest upgrade, so we got that. And now we have another one. We can also get some compact drawers or oak drawer. I sort of want to get the compact ones. Yeah, we'll get compact. I haven't seen the compact ones before, so I sort of want to get them. Actually, the compact... Oh, these ones are actually better. 2x2s. Damn, I should have gone with the 2x2s and not the 1x2s. Can we make these into a 2x2? Drawer upgrade. Or template, whatever it was. Okay, so these things I'm actually going to use for... Well, pretty good use. Not sure where I want them, though. Probably be in a better idea to have them over here, to be honest. Yeah, I guess we can do that. I just need some more living wood, which actually I've got in my inventory because I made some up. So, let's just get this. We will make that into that. Guess that'll do. Let's actually stick some No. Oh, shit, balls. That wasn't meant to do that. I was meant to go and get some cobblestone out of here. There we go. Stack of cobble. Right, there we go. Go over to this again. Stick this in here. At least we got some glass now. Boop. And stick that in there. There we go. Okay, cool. So that should start making up stone, which means we can make some more living rock, which will go well around the outside of this. So that in there, we're going to stick... Oh, we've actually got two more barrels. Awesome. Cool. That means I can use these for something else. Why am I going this way? I think my key just stuck. Whoops. Okay, right. Well, we're about out of hunger on that. Shoot. Funcraft, we don't really need it for. I'm going to stick another one there, and then I'm going to stick one there. I don't really need it at the moment. What's this? Storage upgrade. Slot upgrade. Slots used, one. Increase the storage capacity by 64 stacks. Oh, that's handy to have. And we've also got these as well, so. And we've also got a chest upgrade. Cool. I guess I should probably use this on one of my Funcraft chests. No, that one's already upgraded. That one I don't really need at the moment. This I could do with an upgrade on. So that I've got two separate chests. That'll... Yeah, that's handy. Okay, that'll do. And let's go and check on the stuff over here. We can actually rebind you to the mana pool. There you go. And we can rebind you to that mana pool. There we go. Okay, right. Let's get this real quick. There we go. And I'm going to stick one more down just so that I got that ready. And then with this living rock, we're going to stick it on here. And we're going to go boop. And we get two runes of gluttony. So that's actually better than I had anticipated. And let's get this set up. I don't know how many of these I'm going to need. I might actually just put it next to this. Yeah, let's just stick it here. There we go. Okay, so with that in place, we will get this. And we will stick this here. I've got two of these as well, so I'll stick these here for now, although I might move them later. And then I'm going to stick some... Once I've got enough living rock, I'm going to have it around the outside just so that it looks nicer. And these are going to hold our petals and hopefully our flowers too, because that should work out well. Yeah, I think that'll do. What am I going to do? I'm going to look up the recipe for the Munch Do, the Nommy Nom, the art teacher. Nommy Nommy, the art teacher. Okay. So Munch Do, I need a lime petal, a lime mana petal, a green petal, red mana, white and white mana. Okay, so that shouldn't be too hard, I'm hoping. White mana, red mana, lime mana, and finally a green. I don't see green in here. I'm actually going to take all of these out because I might as well. Shoot. Okay, well, I guess I will make these all into petals and we will stick these into their corresponding places. So, I don't know. Might want this along the top, actually. Oop, get that. And then we will stick this up here. There we go. Okay, right, so white is going to be the first one, which... probably should have had it black, actually. Oh, well, I'm not going to... Oh, God, I just took the whole lot. I want two of those, so into here. There we go. So the first two things are going to be the whites, and I'm actually going to put a Rune of Gluttony on there. Then we're going to need red as well, so we'll get a red one. Stick these on here. And then we're going to need a lime and a lime mana. So stick those on there. The blood moon is rising. That is not good because I do not have lighting here. Oh dear. Well, if anything blows up overnight, we know why. Because I haven't set up a lighting plan. I might want to stick some lights down here and over here and definitely in here. No doubt about that one, right? That one should be fine. I'm hoping it's going to be okay. Okay. Well, we've got eight left. I don't know which areas are dark and which are not, because I don't check things. Guessing this area is going to be a little bit dark. I'm hoping that nothing will spawn. We will soon find out, though. If I explode because of creepers, then at least I know why. Right, anyway, we getting back to topic. Make those into petals. I actually need to go down to the surface and get some green ones. Shit. Okay, lime, I will stick here. I believe there are some greens around here somewhere. There's a green over there. There's lots of creepers being turned into tainted things. Oh, we're good. We're actually good. I've got petals in here I didn't realize I had. Phew, that's lucky then. I guess I'll take that grey one as well. I'll stick that in there for now. Okay, cool. Right, well, I guess we're better off than I had originally anticipated. We will stick one of those into there, and I think that's all we need. Oh, at least I hope it is. Is it? No, it appears not to be. Rune. What do we need? Two. Oh, wait, this is just in the apothecary. Okay, we don't actually need them in here. Phew, that's actually a bit better as well than I had originally anticipated. Right, I'm going to then... Wait, is this a mana one? Ah, shit, that's mana. Crap. I'll stick you in there then. Why not? Grey, we need a light grey. Shite. Just take the whole lot out. Damn it. Okay. Need to make some more of these storage drawers now then. Black can be the first one. Yeah, that'll go for now. Right, okay. It is very red and dark. I hope you guys can see. Right, so apothecary. We actually need all the materials, so... Okay, so in the apothecary, we need all the stuff that we've already had. So this. I think that's everything there. What just happened? Okay. Right, this wants to go in there. We then want... Oh, wait. Come here, you. And that. I think that's everything. I'm hoping that's everything. If that is not everything, then this recipe will not work. And so I need to grab some seeds real quick. We will use the mandrake seeds because I have... Whoa! Shit! Okay, hello, Mr. Zombie. Thank you for warning me. You're now going to shoot me off of here, aren't you? Yes, you are. You little shit! Come here. Yes. You little bugger. Ugh, God, that actually scared me. Right, okay. Seeds in here. There we go. We've got a munch-do! Hey! Okay, cool, right. We are going to stick this one. I want to have it close-ish to this. May stick it somewhere like here. Yeah, I think that would be a good place. Right, that's that. So if we actually... That could be useful. I've just had a good idea. Right, so if we get some tall trees like spruce saplings... Shit! Okay. Creeper didn't creep me out too much. Okay, well, that's destroyed some of the torches, but oh well, oh well. Right, let's grab that. Can you spawn? No, you can't. Okay. Right, we're going to stick these here then. I'm going to stick these all around this, just to make sure that at least one grows, and then we're going to have this moved, and we are going to stick you right here. That should start working now, I'm hoping, which will hopefully make it so that these will grow quicker. Not entirely sure, but just to give them a bit of a kick start, we're going to go whoop. And there you go. You can see that is biting off all of the leaves. Of course, it won't actually chop down the tree, so we do need to do that ourselves. So I'm going to cut that down with this spell. And this spell... There we go. Okay, so this now should be able to work again. Although, to be honest, it uses... I'm actually going to get rid of these spruce because they don't actually generate a lot of leaves, which is actually what we need. So, is there... Oh, there's this freaking skeleton. Hello! I need to get some spells for combat. Ah, there's another one! Die! You bastard. Oh god, I'm actually dying quite quickly. Probably not a good thing. I am low on hunger, I do realise that. Let's... Okay, that only did one. Let's check this bag. Anything good? Oh, we got a knowledge fragment. Cool. Ow. I'm dying slowly again. How long have we got this hunger? 12 seconds. Oh, dear. Right, so I'm trying to figure out what would be the best for leaves. I mean, probably would be oak saplings, really. But I don't know. It might not be, really. Oh, we got another egg. Nope. Nope. No chicken. Right. Let's do this. And then let's do this. There we go. And then let's do this once again. There's a tree. Wait, you're not eating that. Why are you not eating the leaves off of that? Oh, because this has a cooldown on it, I believe. So any mana going to it. Wait, is this actually connected? I'm hoping that's connected. Hello? Munchdew connected to this. This is connected to this. This is nearly full. Oh, there we go. It's eating it again. I forgot it had a cooldown timer. There we go. Cool. Right, that's working. Good. Right, so I will just need to take these down every now and again. So, means I also get some wood. So, that is actually pretty handy. Right, we'll leave that for a little while just to do that job. So, we should now be getting more mana than we were. Oh, God, that's in the way. Oh, fudge. Okay, I guess I'm going to have to move this then. Balls. I haven't thought that one through, had I? Okay, so I guess since I need to anyway... Ooh. I guess since I need to anyway, I might as well make some more compact oak drawers so we can see how to do those. So I'm going to go over here and get that. Not sure how to. Let's have a look up the recipe. So, compact. There we go. Right, so we need, oh god, four chests. Four chests and a load of, basically, planks. Hmm. Okay, then. I don't have any oak wood. Okay, so let's make a few chests out of these. And we should get enough stuff out of this. So let's get four of those with a load of planks of wood. I've made too many planks, but we do get four per thing anyway. So we didn't actually need to get all of that. Damn it. Oh, well, we've got plenty anyway. So if we need them any other time, or if we need another one any other time, then we've got it. Okay, so these can now be color-coded, I guess, if I have the right colors for them. So I guess I should probably go get light gray. There's mystic gray and there's light gray. We could get black because we've already got that placed in there. So I'm literally just color coding these up to the variants that they should be. So I'm probably going to do this off camera just so you guys don't have to go through the agonizing torture that it is of me organizing shit. So yeah. But we will be back once I have finished organizing these then. Okay, so I think I'm about done on these. I've just got to do the last few here. I don't actually have a blue, so I won't be able to put that in. But for the most part, I've got these about color coordinated. I'm just going to put these black lotuses in here because I didn't realize I had any. So like that, let's fill that up a little bit. And then we can go in here and put purple there. We can put light blue down here. As I say, we don't have any normal blue, so I'm not going to be able to do that. And then we can put lime in that one. And then some light pinks in this one. So for the most part, that looks about right. So hoping that it is. And then we can go like that. There we go. Right, so we're just missing the blue one, and I got brown down there. So these are all color-coded now, apart from white, which we have in... Did I lose my whites? Yep, so it appears that I have lost all my white petals unless I'm stupid and can't actually see them. So that is not a good thing because white was one of the main dominant ones that I needed. Slightly annoying. Slightly very annoying. You keep generating mana for me, please, Mr. Munchdo. You're doing a good job of it so far. Right, so I won't actually get any saplings back for this either, because the Munchdo doesn't allow sapling returns. So, not good. But we should be fine, because I've got plenty of oak saplings here anyway. So, I'm just going to stick these down here just to make sure that these grow. Not bothered if they actually do or not. So, we got another one there as well, ready for more mana. Right, how is this one doing? Because we could get started on the gateway. Yes. That's probably something that I should do. But instead of getting started on the gateway, I'm actually going to start working on something else because it is a pretty cool thing that we're going to get. So I need a curative vat, which is fairly, it's fairly expensive, really, when you look at it. But for this, we are going to need an alchemical construct, which is 2 essentia valves, 4 essentia tubes and 2 vis filters, so pretty pricey. And then we're going to need a great wood plank. I'm not sure how many of those I have left, if any at all. We have planks. Okay, good. We do actually have planks. Not that we actually have any great wood itself. I might have a sapling around here somewhere. I'm really hoping that I do. Is that great wood? Yes, that is a great wood. Great! We'll stick that down there. Okay, cool. Right, let's get started on this then. I will get mainly the bits that I need because you guys have already seen me make them before. Okay, so apparently our thing here's gone. I don't know when that happened or how that happened, but apparently it's gone. Not sure what to do with that. Oh well, right, so I'm actually going to just quickly make this on camera because you guys probably haven't seen this one or me do this one. So we're going to get some valves, or I hope these are valves. Yes, they're valves. Good, right, that's that. Okay, so to make this, I'm hoping I've got this right. Not sure how it completely goes. I know those go like that. 2 valves either side, and then I believe it is great wood plank in the middle. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so we got 1 alchemical construct. Now, I do need 2 of these, so I'm going to do that. We're going to do... Actually, no, I need another one of those vis filter thingies, so... Oops, wrong. There we go. So, alchemical construct, and there it is. Okay, cool. Right, well, we've got those. Now, we have to set up the rest of the system, which I'm actually going to grow this great wood thing, so it actually... turns into something, or I'm hoping this will grow it. Nope, that didn't do a thing. Oh, it's doing some... That didn't do anything still. Heh. Okay, that's not actually doing anything. That's not a good thing. I wonder if I could use these bones to bone meal it. I don't know if that works. I can't remember if that works or not. Nope, that does not work. Okay, well, anyway, we are going to go over here, and we are going to set this thing up. So, I'm not sure where to set this up, really. I need it in my formic area, so I may just make a place behind this area of stuff. Yeah, that'll be a good idea. Okay, so we've got this bit finished. Let's then look at the recipe real quick for the curative vat. So we need it in a 9 area, so great wood planks we're going to need plenty of. I'm hoping that tree grows by the end of the episode. Right, so I'm going to stick this then. Let's see, we don't want it right on the edge, but here... Yeah, we'll stick it here. Okay, so we've got 1 construct at the bottom. We then need a layer of great wood, which is going to be sort of like this, I believe. And then we need glass, so we need lots of... Oh, I say about the tree, and then it grows. Ha ha, yay. Right, so I'm going to be using a lot of magic. And that's actually lagging my game out a little bit. Okay, so something I did discover between episodes, I don't think I've said anything about this, is a block that allows me to actually place it down on taint, and it won't actually spread, or the taint won't spread to the actual block. So it's infused with taint, therefore it won't have it. So those blocks could be handy if I wanted to make a stairwell up to this area rather than having just a ladder that takes forever to climb. So that could be a handy thing to think about, but at the moment as it stands I'm not going to do that because it's going to take a lot of the damn stuff, so not too bothered. But let's have a look in here. This was actually planks, wasn't it? Yes. So we need about 16 glass. I've got some sand here that we can actually put into here to smelt up, so that is going to come in handy. And I'm actually going to get the top piece of this done as well. I like the look of these constructs. They're pretty cool design. I like them. They are very good. Thank you, Asnor. Okay, that's four. So that's one. Oh, can't get in there that way, can I? Shoot. Two, three, four, okay. And then another few here, so another two, so one, two. Now we do need water in the middle, so I should probably go and collect some water because I don't believe that I have any. So have we got some buckets here? Yes, we do. We only need two lots of water, so I will go and do that. This tree is taking a while to chop down. Oh, another tree's going. Oh, another two trees going. Oh, we got an apple. Oh no, just another tree. Oh god, even more. Oh, that thing's gonna have a feast today. Oh, I didn't quite dig all the trees up. Oh, welly, welly, well. Okay, so I guess I should probably get the bottom done so that I can stick the water in. So let's do this. This should be enough glass. I'm hoping. Right, that's the bottom piece done. Oh, we need one more. God damn. Right, actually, I'm going to take this construct out first. And I'm actually going to leave that for now. We'll grab this piece of glass if we can. Get rid of that arrow. Don't need you. Get that glass there. There we go. Got some more. And we'll stick this on there. There we go. So pretty much sort of looks the way that the other thing, the giant node jar thing did. Right, that should go there, and now we should just need to click this with a wand to complete it, which I don't actually have my wand. Okay, so we should have everything in here that we need, so... Whoa! Okay then, that actually looks really freaking sweet. Oh, well, we're not drowning. Can I get... Yeah, there we go. Okay, cool. Okay, right, so this thing... This is a UI that I haven't seen before. Right, I think we need to filter things in. Let's have a look. So, with your newfound understanding of tissue replication, it should be possible to adapt your technique... It should be possible to adapt these techniques to rapidly heal a creature's wounds. This procedure is rather delicate and cannot be performed with a crucible. Instead, you have designed a specialized vat which diagnoses the patient and pipes in the appropriate essentia to treat them. Victus restores lost health, albeit slowly. Fames refills the hunger bar. Oh, that's pretty cool to have. Sano quickly restores the health. It also nullifies those negative status effects. Okay, cool. To enter, blah, blah, blah. Suspecting that your vat can be... further improved, you have designed a hatch to double as a extension port. Okay, that seems pretty cool. So this is also an extension port, which it looks like. Okay, then. So I did get Incarnation, which is the thing that I want this for. So what's this? Nutrient mix. Oh, that's what that little slot is in there. Okay. So for this, you are tantalizingly close to mastering life itself. It is time to take the next step. Artificially birthing whole organisms. This procedure can be performed in a unmodified curative vat, but it does require a few special reagents. The first of these is tissue sample from the creature. To be cloned. Okay, so I guess that means like ham and stuff. Piece of meat or a warded syringe filled with creature's blood. Okay, right, so we can do like pigs and stuff. Once the sample is in place, piping four Victus Essentia into the vat will ignite its growth. Finally, the clone will require large amounts of nourishment to reach its adult size. You have developed an optimized nutrient mixture for this process. When all reagents have been added, the clone will rapidly grow to its adult size. You may extract your creation by right-clicking the vat with a warded jar. Oh, okay. The incarnation process has one curious limitation. While cloned animals develop their own souls during the growth process, apparently by coalescing some of the local aura. Okay, that's pretty cool. It cannot replicate a human soul, dooming human clones to failure. Okay, so that's the way around that one. Breaking the vat which contains a creature will likely be fatal. Does that mean the creature will just die, or does that mean that something else bad could happen? I'm hoping that just means that the creature will die. Okay, so we need some nutrient mix, which... how do we get that? We need sugar and fames or whatever. Okay, that seems like it could be doable. So I will need another watered jar, so I'll just get that ready now. So let's do this. And actually, no, we need some glass. I know I'm probably going over on time limit on this video. I apologize for that if I am. I just want to get this done. We need our wand in there. Get that. There we go. And right, so I will put this. Nope, not that one. I will put this one, the Victus jar, down here. I will then go and grab some piping so that we can pipe this into the machine. I believe it only required four per animal, so it's not a great amount, really. So like that, I actually needed three. Crap. Do you connect? Yes, you connect. Okay, cool. Right, so we've got that in there. Now we need the nutrients mix and the flesh of the animal that we want to do. So I sort of want to go for a piggy, but I don't know if I have any piggy stuff. Do I? I have cow. I don't have piggy, I just have cow. Okay, well, I guess we'll go for a cow then. So sugar is one of the things that we are required for this. So... let's see, sugar, we got sugarcane here, so five should do, I'm hoping. We'll probably need a lot more than that, actually, from what I can work out. We also need fames, which I believe we actually probably get off of meat. No, we just get life off of meat. Okay, so what about rotten flesh? No, okay. Where do we get fames from, then? Okay, so we can get fames and stuff off of things such as wheat. So that's a good thing because we should have a bit of that hopefully in here. We'd also get it off of carrots, melon. Ooh, melon is a good one. Okay, melon primarily has it, so we've done pretty well then because we have a whole melon farm. Well, technically, melon slice farm. We've also got wheat there as well, so I'm glad that I started making melons now. Huh. Okay, so I've got plenty of famous here. I'm hoping this equals to 8. I will just quickly check to make sure that it does. Yep, there we go, 8. So we're going to stick this in here, and then we're going to stick around about 4 sugar in. I think that should be enough. One more. There we go, right, we've got the nutritional stuff anyway, so hopefully, I'm not sure how much this is going to cost me, but we'll stick that in there anyway, and we will stick some beef in there. I'm not sure how much of this we need either. Oh, that's doing something. Ooh, look at the beef. Look at that piece of beef. Oh. What? Oh, we got some hearts. Oh dear. Oh dear. Oh god, I should have had a valve. Is that made the creature? Oh, I can see a creature. We've got a cow. We have a cow. It's not fully there, but we have a cow. What do I do? Do I need the other jar? Crap, has this got stuff in it? Shit. Mr. Cow is looking pretty good. Pretty damn good. Right, I guess we just need to make this final jar, because I actually used the jars up so that I could get some other stuff. So I'm going to need to make another water jar. I don't think I've got any in here. Nope. Okay, one final water jar, then we should be able to get Mr. Cow, and then we should be able to end the episode. I'm hoping. No, I don't want that like that. I want it like that, which means that we can get that. There we go. Okay, cool, right. I need to check the nourishment thing on here as well. Right, this needs to go here, so Mr. Golem can interact with it. I think that's going okay. Actually, what did I... Oh, fuck. I done it again, didn't I? Yep, I did. I fucking did. I didn't need to put it down, did I? Shit's sake. I swear, man, the amount of water jars that I've gone through, god damn it. Okay, well, Mr. Cow looks pretty much done. Have I got it? Yeah, I have a jarred cow. Okay, that is pretty damn cool, right. Okay, well, I need to set up another farm area. I'm going to get another cow, and then I guess we will have it so that we actually have a decent farm, so that we can actually then breed cows, slaughter the cows, and then we'll be able to get the flour that eats meat, which will hopefully generate us even more mana. We don't actually need mana in this anymore, which means that this can go over here, which means this is the only pool we need to finish filling up. Which is great. So, yeah. But anyway, guys, I'm ending the episode here. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Remember, if you did, give it a thumbs up. And we will continue this endeavor in the next episode. I also got some more of those seed things so we can plant some more hydrangeas here. So, that will be good. But anyway, guys, hope you enjoyed. Blah, 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 blah. I am Pokepeel. This is Hubris. And I will see you guys next time. So, until then, bye!